Hey, how you doing? It's Clayton here, and welcome to HowToDrawComics.net. In today's video, what I'd like to talk about is moving on from artistic or creative defeat. You know, as artists, especially artists who are still in the beginning stages of learning, there's a lot of barriers that we have to break through. And one of the major barriers that I know I started out having to face, and this is the case for many others and many of my students that I've taken under my wing in the classroom and outside of the classroom, is it's very discouraging when you create an artwork that you had the highest hopes for and it just does not work out in the end. For one reason or another, as hard as you tried, as careful as you were, as particular and analytical as you could have been, it still just ends up crumbling to the ground. It just doesn't end up looking right. The characters are out of proportion, the anatomy is in the wrong place, and the overall composition just isn't aesthetically pleasing. It's not going to, you know, turn heads, so to speak. And, you know, you just want to throw it in the bin. And, of course, that really tends to... It gives your artistic ego a hit, you know? Not in a positive way. It takes a hit. And it can really bring down your inner morale. In other words, you don't really feel like having another go. You don't really feel like going back to the drawing board and failing again. And so the fallout from these artistic hiccups can really hinder you as an artist and your motivation to move forward, which, of course, is a toxic way of looking at things, especially as an artist, because most of your illustrations aren't going to be perfect. And I know there's different levels of not being perfect. You know, they may not be perfect, but for some, they may get it pretty close to perfect, or they may get it pretty close to how they want it to be. For others, however, who, again, are just starting out, the artistic failures that they'll have to face are usually quite noticeable and quite gigantic. It's something that when they look down onto the page, they really start to question themselves and whether or not it's worth their while pursuing the artistic passion that they've chosen to pursue. It can really cause you to ask yourself as a person, am I supposed to be an artist, or should I be really looking into something different? Should I go for something else that maybe I'm not as passionate about, but I could be better at? Here's the thing, no matter what skill it is you're trying to harness, you're going to have this learning curve happen. It's going to take you a certain amount of time for you to get your artistic abilities from level A to level B, to level C, to level D and E. You know, the different levels as to where you can take your artwork to are going to be endless, essentially. Unless you stop drawing, you're never going to stop improving. And so I think that it's certainly worth your while to try to get your head in a place where it's okay to mess up from time to time. It's okay for you to have those duds that just get thrown into the paper bin. But I wouldn't throw them away. I would keep them because, you know, being an artist, it's one of those wonderful opportunities where you can keep your sketchbooks and the volumes that you've gone through and look back later on and see the artistic journey that you've embarked on to see how far you've come. There's not a lot of things where you can do that, where you can see the history of your development in some craft, in some field of work. A lot of the time you just kind of improve and you don't really notice it. But, you know, you're essentially cataloging your journey as an artist when you can keep those works in your sketchbook. And it's really good to look back on them, because the one thing that you should never do necessarily is compare yourself to other artists as far as, you know, how much you build yourself up to move forward. You should only compare yourself to yourself and your own progress, the point to which you've come as an artist and the strides you've made, the mileage that you've got behind you. Because that's really the real true look at your progress and whether or not you're improving. So I think that realistically it's important to make sure that you've got those old pieces of artwork there that you've created, that you've put love into, that have history behind them. This is your artistic history, and history isn't always pretty. You know, like there's going to be battles that you're going to have to fight in order to get to that next point. And it's unfortunate, yes. You know, I've definitely had, especially when you get to a point where you think you're okay and then you mess up, that's even more discouraging because as you continue improving, you start to construct this artistic identity, this model of yourself as an artist. And you tell yourself things about yourself. You know, you say, well, yeah, you know, I'm really great at drawing, let's say, female characters. I'm really great at drawing male characters or superheroes or, you know, monsters or creatures. Or I'm really great at drawing backgrounds. I'm really great at rendering. I'm really great at drawing figures in proportion. I have a lot of energy behind my characters. And then when you draw a piece of artwork that doesn't necessarily have those things, those attributes that you've identified yourself with, and you look at it, you start to question yourself. You're like, but I thought that I was this. I thought that I was good at doing this particular thing. Like, I thought I had this mastered. And when you realize that you haven't yet mastered it, which, you know, you'd never really truly 100% master anything, it kind of, again, it really gets you questioning yourself and the solidarity that you might build as an artist. Because I think that in the end, a confident artist is going to make the best type of art. That's when you're going to start to see the energy behind the work. That's when you're going to see that unconscious competence start to shine through. But when you start to question yourself, then all of a sudden your confidence takes a dip. And that can, of course, end up manifesting within the finished artwork that you do from that point onward. And you see that unconfidence, you see that overanalysis, that careful way of working that the artist has taken on board because their confidence has taken a bit of a beating, their artistic ego, so to speak. So, you know, these things can, of course, you know, hinder you as an artist, and it hinders you in the quality of your work that you end up producing going forward, and it can hinder you in your motivation to go forward at all. Again, it causes you to question whether or not this is something that you should even be doing in the first place. But it's always worth it. You know, if you really want to draw comic books, if you really just want to be an artist in general, whether it be a concept artist, a storyboard artist, you know, a video game artist, a set designer, whatever it is, whatever form you want your artwork to take, it's worth pursuing if you're passionate about it, and use that passion to push you forward no matter what. Know that you're going to make mistakes, that you're going to have setbacks, and that is totally and 100% fine. That is supposed to happen. That's a normal thing to happen. If you're having setbacks, then that means you're learning, and that's always a good thing. It means that you are taking steps toward a better quality of art for yourself, a higher tier of expertise that you're ascending to. Because, you know, if you don't move forward at all, if you don't make those mistakes, then there's no way that you can level up, right? So it's inevitable that you're going to have to make them, and that if you are making them, it is a good thing. It means that you're getting that mileage behind you. You have to make mistakes so that you can hone in on them, so that you can shine a light on them and avoid them in the future. And that way, you know, hopefully you won't make them again. They'll be cataloged in the back of your mind, and you'll be able to avoid them from that point onward, or at least figure out a way to navigate around them. You know, these mistakes are always going to happen. You'll always have your weaknesses as an artist. But the idea, as you develop your skill set, is to strategize your way around them, to come up with methods and techniques for yourself, you know, shorthand approaches that allow you to overcome them in the most optimal way possible, that allow you to... And that's really what I think, you know, getting better as an artist is all about, is just finding your own approach to these things, to your own style. It's almost your own style of battling through the setbacks that you're going to face, the weaknesses within your work. At least that's what I've found. You know, there's still parts of my artwork that I get nervous about, especially if I'm drawing a character on a tricky angle. You know, it might be their head, for example, or it might be their hands. I find hands very tricky. I find feet very tricky. In general, I get nervous about every drawing that I go into, if I'm being honest. And that can freak you out a little bit, and it can stifle your the quality of your work to an extent, because you do end up being too careful. You become self-conscious. And being self-conscious with your work is a good thing in some aspects, because it allows you to, again, allows you to hone your perspective in and your attention in on those areas that you're messing up within your artwork. But it can also, it's also a bad thing in a way, because it causes you to overanalyze your work and overanalyze yourself. It makes you insecure about the work that you're creating. And that insecurity is going to affect the lines that you place down onto the page, the way that you, the risks that you might take, which ultimately end up as something better than you would have ended up with if you were careful the entire time. Because being an artist, a great artist, is all about taking those risks. It's all about, you know, doing something that you haven't explored before, especially as a comic book artist. If you're not used to being outside of your comfort zone, then that's where you're going to run into the most problems, because you're constantly thrown out into a field of subject matter that you're not, it's impossible to be familiar with at all, because the script that you're drawing from is going, could ask you to draw all sorts of things within that narrative. You might be really, really great at drawing cityscapes, for example, you know, drawing superhero comics. You know, you usually got Superman and where's his environment? Metropolis, right? You got him in Metropolis, you've got Batman and Gotham City, great. You might be really good at drawing cityscapes. But what if then you get assigned a comic book where you're drawing like a medieval comic, right? And you haven't drawn a castle for a very, very long time. And you don't know how to draw, you know, different landscapes and terrains in that particular genre, right? So you really have to be able to, and hey, I don't know how to draw everything either. So the trick is not knowing how to draw it necessarily, you know, but doing as much research as you can, and then doing your best to navigate around that particular issue, that discomfort that you might be feeling. Because when you venture into it and you go head on into that area where you're uncomfortable, right, that's where you're going to learn the most. Because everything you've done up until that point that you're comfortable with, you already know. It's fine. Like, you can refine it and you can tweak it and you can get a little bit better at it. But the areas that you know nothing about, that you venture into, you know, the uncharted territory, so to speak, that's where you're going to learn the most. And that's where you're going to get the greatest bang for your buck as well, because that's, you know, you're starting off from a place of not knowing anything, and then all of a sudden you're leveling up with all this new knowledge that, and this new experience that you've never had before. It's impossible not to improve from where you were at that point. And that is a good thing. You know, just because you're uncomfortable doesn't mean it's bad. I know that we're kind of wired to think that discomfort is a bad thing, but I think anything worth doing is going to be uncomfortable at first. But I'm sure in your own life, if you think back to all some of the greatest points within your life, you know, the most memorable points, they were points in your life that you were uncomfortable to venture into at first, right? It might have been, and I'm talking about, you know, outside of comic book illustration as well. You know, it might have been going to your uni course for the first time, you know, jumping into the classroom, right? But hey, you know what? Maybe you made a lot of great friends from that and met a lot of cool teachers. It could have been that first date, you know, highly uncomfortable, but maybe, you know, that ends up panning out in the end and you end up having a great relationship blossoms from it. Or, you know, there's so many things in life, you know, going into your first job, you know, maybe you've scored a gig in a studio. That's obviously nerve-wracking, but leads to some great things oftentimes. If it's memorable and it's a pinnacle point within your lifetime, that's going to usually be a point at which you felt uncomfortable at first, and then you went into it, you fought through that, and ultimately it turned out for the best. The same deal with your artwork. You know, the things that you venture into that you're most uncomfortable with, that's going to be the most significant growing points within your artistic journey. And so it's a good thing. You know, I want you to know that you shouldn't be discouraged with this stuff, because you are going to mess up. It's inevitable. I still mess up, and you will always mess up. That's just part of the territory. I think what makes you a great artist isn't necessarily being great at what you do, but working through the things that you're not so great at. So keep that in mind, because that's the skill that you really need to focus on in developing. That's what will make you a great artist, is working through the hiccups that you face along the way. And I really just wanted to put this video out there, because I do know how discouraging it is when you mess up on a piece of artwork and you question yourself. And, you know, I think that the best thing to do when it comes to learning how to draw comic books and learning how to hone your craft in any form of art and entertainment is to not identify yourself too much with your work. You know, that was one of the greatest things that that I ever heard from, you know, a very special person in my life. And yeah, she said, don't identify. She tells her students not to identify themselves with their art. And it always helps, because I think that that's something that we do a lot. And it can really mess with us in a big way, because it's important to realize that we're not our art, and that regardless of its quality, it doesn't change who we are as a person. We're the one in control, we're the one who can make it better, we're the one who can put in the effort and continue growing. The artwork is just going to be whatever it's going to be at the end of the day, and that's totally fine. That's what it is supposed to be. In the end, it's really just a gift to the world. You know, you do your best, and I think that's the most important and most... It's very simple. It's a very simple message, but it's a very profound message as well, is that, you know, in the end, you can only do your best. And I think that that's something that I've come to terms with quite recently as well, is, you know, just being okay with that. Being okay with doing my best. Not necessarily, you know, trying to measure up to the unrealistic expectations and ideals that I might have, but just doing my best with every piece that I sit down to draw. If I know that I've done my best, then that's the level of perfectionism that I should strive for next time. Not the unrealistic expectations that I might have. And we all have those unrealistic expectations because, you know, the artists that we admire most, that most inspire us, that's what got us into this in the first place. And when we're comparing our work to them, of course, it's going to take us a long time to get to that point. So, you know, it's, yeah, okay, totally. You know, use Jim Lee and Mark Silvestri. You know, these are my inspirations. But, you know, whoever your inspirations are, as a propellant to move forward, to keep on going, you know, to push you to that next level. But don't necessarily compare your work to them in a negative light, because they're masters. They've been mastering their craft for, you know, decades. And if you're just starting out, then there's no way that you're going to be able to measure up to that level of quality. But you can measure up to the level of quality that you last were able to pull off within your artwork. So, you know, I would say use that as a form of encouragement, and never give up. Continue pushing forward regardless. I would say if you're defeated with one artwork, you know, you mess up and it doesn't quite turn out the way that you wanted it to, instead of, you know, feeling discouraged, use that to push yourself even harder the next time around. You know, really analyze it. Look at the areas in which you can improve. You know, it's a gold mine of improvement, potential improvement that you could make. If the proportions were at, really take note of that. Where were the proportions at? Was it the entire figure where the proportions were messed up, or was it just the size of the head? Was it the size of the legs? Right? Really look at that. What anatomy was messed up specifically? Was it the anatomy within the arms? What muscles within the arms were messed up? You know, really hone in on that and take note of it, because the more specific you can get, you know, be a detective, an artistic detective within your own work. Look for the clues that are going to allow you to get better as an artist, and you'll notice that the quality of your work just jumps and leaps and bounds, and you know, the sky's the limit with this stuff. You know, all you have to do to get better, to get to the point at which you want to be with your artwork, is keep going. So do not give up, and I can guarantee you that you will keep on growing. Just make sure that you learn from your past defeats, right? Don't give up. Overcome them and learn from them. Well, I hope that you enjoyed this video. Thanks so much for watching. If you'd like more comic art tips, tricks, and tutorials, be sure to visit www.howtodrawcomics.net, and I'll see you there. Until next time, keep on creating and keep on practicing.